Perfect.
Hey everybody, Tribe Nursing here. Today I'm going to be covering a video about how I study with the nursing school. Many of you have asked how I study. I'm going to be giving detailed explanations on how I study. I've compared my study methods to my classmates' study methods, and it has been shown that our study methods were very similar, although we did take separate paths as far as rewriting our notes, but I'll go into that a lot more during this video. If you are new to my channel, make sure to give it a like and subscribe. Also, never miss another one of my videos. All you have to do is hit the bell button so you can be notified for every single time I upload a video. Also, if you haven't followed me on any of my social media, you can follow me on my Instagram and Twitter. With all that being said, let's get started. As I mentioned earlier, this video is going to be a pretty detailed explanation on how I study. I've been using the same method throughout all my nursing courses in my nursing program, and my success rate has been very high by using these methods. Okay, so tip number one, before starting any of your nursing courses, make sure to read the lectures and PowerPoints before going to class. The reason I say this is because before you go to class, when you read the PowerPoint and the assigned readings, it increases the retention during class, so you understand a lot more on what the professor is talking about during lecture. Therefore, you are going to retain a lot more information during those lectures and participate so much more. So it has been proven that if you read the PowerPoints and the chapters before class, you retain so much more information during the lecture. And as you go back to study that material later on, you can grasp that material so much better because you've read the material, such as the PowerPoints and the chapters, before coming to class. So it is very significant for you to actually read the PowerPoint lectures and the chapters before coming to class. Also, it allows you to ask proper questions that is relatable to the material that the professor is covering that day. So by you reading or skimming the PowerPoints and the chapters before coming to class, it allows you to populate a few questions that you may not understand, and then you can ask those questions during lecture. Also, when you ask a question, it's going to trigger someone else to ask a question as well. And from there, we have a dialogue of that material. So it allows individuals and yourself to grasp that material so much more because your classmates are able to participate and ask questions as well, and the professor will be able to respond back to it. The second tip that I can give you is recording your lecture. Although, make sure to email your professor to make sure that it is okay to record the lectures before actually recording it. The reason why recording your lectures are so important is because during class, you miss so much material that has been covered within that lecture. Sometimes the professor might be moving way too fast, and it results in you missing material that he or she spoke about. Therefore, by recording your lectures, it allows you to go back to the material that you have missed and rewrite that material so you can understand it. Also, by you going back and re-listening to that lecture, that is called passive learning. As you are studying, you should be using passive learning and active learning. So, some examples of passive learning versus active learning is that passive learning, you are watching YouTube videos, such as the video that you're watching right now, you are listening to podcasts, you are reading the textbook, you are reading the lectures. Those are examples of passive learning. Active learning, on the other hand, active learning is when the student is actually doing an activity, such as teaching somebody else on the whiteboard, yourself going on the whiteboard and regurgitating material that you have learned that day for your exams, participating in class discussions, as well as participating in case studies. So the app that I use to record my lectures is called Notability. I use this app specifically on my iPad, And it is honestly, in my opinion, the greatest note-taking app that you can use on the iPad Pro. The reason why this app is good for recording your lectures is because you can go to the exact spot on where your professor was talking about a specific subject. My classmates, on the other hand, also use their phones to record the lectures using the Voice Memo app, but I found it more beneficial to use Notability on your iPad. If you do have one, I advise you to definitely use Notability to be more successful during your class lectures. With the Voice Memo app, you are unable to go back to the exact moment, but with Notability, you can literally click on the word and it brings you to the exact moment the professor is talking about a specific subject within that lecture. So after I record my lecture from that day, I pack my stuff up, I go to the library, and I rewrite everything that the professor spoke that day. The reason why I rewrite my notes the same day is because the material is already fresh in your brain. Therefore, it allows you to recall the material that your professor spoke about that day. There is actually a study that for every day that you wait after you've learned a new skill or something specific within your studies, you lose 10% of that material that you've learned that day. So that's the reason why I rewrite my notes the same exact day. If you are unable to get to that material that same day, I rewrite my notes the next day. So I am able to retain that material. The way I rewrite my notes is using the note card method. I go through each slide within my notes and rewrite everything within that slide, and then I write everything the professor spoke about into note cards. The reason I use the note card method is because I'm using passive and active learning at the same exact time. So the reason that the note card method is passive and active learning is because as I'm rewriting my notes, I am reading that material back to myself. And then it is active learning as I'm flipping back and forth and speaking it out loud. My classmates, on the other hand, like to rewrite their notes using a notebook, or they like to rewrite their notes on a Google Doc, so they have a master sheet. But you can also do that with a note card method. On the other hand, I also use the chapter readings as a part of a way of studying for my note cards as well. If I see something that's important within the text, I also make a note card of it. So after rewriting my notes, watching videos, and reading the chapters, I make a master set of note cards that I am able to use for passive learning and active learning. So after I made all my note cards, I finally am able to study the material. Typically, by the time I rewrite all my notes, the weekend has already occurred, so it is probably Friday at this point. I've rewritten all my note cards from the week, and now I am able to engrave that material in my head. I make sure to go to my comfortable study spot. I prefer my school. And what I do, I study that material thoroughly by also watching videos and using my note cards as a way of studying. So after I went through my note cards quite a few times, I make sure to go on the whiteboard and use active learning by talking things out to myself, proving that you understand it and able to talk that material out to yourself. So just to reiterate in how I study the material thoroughly, I use my note cards, I use the whiteboard, I watch videos on things that I am still unsure about, and I also go back to the chapter readings for detailed explanations of certain subject matters. So after I've studied all the material that my professor has given me, at this point, the exam is typically 4 to 5 days away. So at this point, I'm just reviewing the material that I've learned, but now is a time to form study groups. The reason why study groups are so important in nursing school is because your classmates may understand something that you don't understand, and you understand something that your classmates don't understand. So it works both ways. Also, the reason why study groups are so important is because sometimes you may have missed something the professor spoke about or a question a classmate asked. So your classmate is able to bring that subject up that you have missed. Therefore, you are able to understand that material. The reason this is important is because sometimes a professor may ask a question about that specific subject that you may have missed. But thankfully, you formed that study group so you won't miss that question. That is the reason why study groups are so important in nursery school. When I form a study group, I usually have not more than four people in a study group. I like to have 2 to 3 other people with me during a study group because anything more than four people become distracting and can throw off the vibe during the study session. So I like to have 2 to 3 people with me as I study. Also, I make sure to have whiteboards around me because if a student doesn't understand something, I am able to explain it actively on the whiteboard so they could understand it. And then somebody else in my study group can join and use the whiteboard to help explain something else. So after you've formed your study group and you have studied all of the material, you've rewritten all your notes, and you feel really good about the material, the most important part is to do critical thinking questions. The reason why I say to do critical thinking questions is so you can apply the material that you have learned. I personally like to do 20 to 30 questions a day before I go to bed, is so I can apply what I've learned that day and see where I'm rusty on as far as knowledge-based questions. Also, the importance of critical thinking question is to allow you to read the rationales if you don't understand a certain question. By reading the rationales, it gives you a great explanation of why you got that question wrong. So if I got a question wrong, I was able to go back to it and understand why I got it wrong. So now you won't miss that question on an exam. Okay, so that is the end of my video. So these were my ways how I studied throughout nursery school, and it has been shown for myself to be very productive. Although every person is different when it comes to studying, so remember that your way of studying might be different than my way of studying. But if you stick to everything I've told you, it will allow you to pave a path of success as you're taking your nursing exams, because your final grades are based off your exams. So at the end of the day, you have to do well on your exams to be successful within the program. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you haven't, and share it with your friends as well. And with all that being said, hopefully you have a great day, and thank you for watching. Tribe Nursing signing out.